Hello everybody! A lot of time has passed since I released my last video. But guys, I didn't forget about you. And today I'm going to start a new interesting topic. Software architecture of an automated trading system. But before we start talking about software architecture, let's try to understand what a trading system is and what it consists of. So, in this video we will discuss the structure and elements of an automated trading system. Let's go! Well, I will say there is nothing new under the sun. Some years ago, when I started, I tried to find a good structured description of trading system. So, the ones that makes it easy to understand which blocks we need to implement and how to create a good software. And I found such description in the book of Rishi Kanaragan, Inside the Black Box. He describes a quantitative system that consists of five common blocks: alpha model, risk model, transaction cost model, portfolio construction model, and execution model. And also one additional block, data. Let's have a closer look at this structure and start from the data block. As you may see, the data block is not a part of the trading system, but the data are like an oxygen, which all components of the system use. The data block contains all kinds of data that the trading system requires. The data can come from many different data sources. Here you can see some of them. Exchanges provide the information about price, volume, order book information. Regulators provide the information about insider purchases and financial statements. From the news agencies, you can receive press releases and news articles. And there are many other data sources that can provide you with information like microeconomics data, broker fees, portfolio information, and so on. Now, when we know what the data block is, let's have a look at the trading system elements and the relationships between them. The arrows shown here represent an information flow. Here, the alpha, risk, and transaction cost models don't take any final decision. They only provide information to the portfolio construction model, which triggers the execution model. Of course, there are many strategies where only a few of these elements are present. Also, the relationship between the elements could be different. However, this structure helps us to see the all main elements of a trading system. The first element in the presented structure is alpha model. It is a trading idea, strategy, that is designed to predict the future. Normally, the output from this model is a return or a direction forecast. There exist two well-known types of trading models. Technical models that use price data and based on the technical analysis, and fundamental models that use financial data and based on the fundamental analysis. Also, we can define the third type of models, which are a mix of the first two. All these models could be simple or quite complex, but the main point of this block is that the model just gives an advice in the form of forecasting the direction or return. The second element is the risk model. The risk model are designed to help, if not completely eliminate, then at least minimize the amount of exposure to those factors that could drive losses. In general, risk models can be of two types. The models of the first type try to reduce risk by defining the size of the position. It could be, for example, a hard sizing strategy or a complex function. In any case, the output from the risk model will be the position size. The second type of risk models tries to reduce the type of risk. For example, market direction risk. In this case, the output of the model could be a hedge position. The next element of the trading system is a transaction cost model. This model is designed to provide the information about the cost of making any given trade. There are three main costs present: fees, slippage, and market impact. As usual, the transaction cost models can be very simple, like a flat model that always returns the same value of transaction cost, or can be complex, for example, quadratic cost function, like the ones that return the predicted cost as close as possible to the real cost. You can see on the graph below how different functions work. Okay, now, when all the elements that provide information are known, we go to the Prtfolio construction model. As you can see, Prtfolio construction model has inputs from alpha, risk and transaction cost models, and decide how to allocate your money between different assets, or tries to construct a portfolio based on some objective function. There are basically two types of Prtfolio construction models. First, as a rule-based construction models, like equal wage, equal risk, decision trees method, and so on. The second type of portfolio construction models are portfolio optimizers. Here, you try to optimize an objective function for a better asset allocation in the portfolio. And the last, but not the least, element of the trading system is the execution model. The execution model receives information from the construction model and tries to execute the order at the best price. There are many different types of execution models. Some of them very simple, like market or limit orders. Some are complex. For example, those that analyze the market microstructure and use the machine learning algorithms. Well, it was a brief description of the main elements of the quantitative trading system. Now, I hope you have a better understanding of the trading system structure and of the way the trading system works in general. In the next videos, I'll try to create a software architecture based on these descriptions. If it's interesting for you, don't forget to subscribe and see you in the next video. Bye-bye!